Good evening, good evening. We welcome you to Kingdom Combustion. I am Apostle Sonia Chambers, and we're just gonna encourage you to come on in. We're gonna give each and every one of you a chance to get in. Come in worshiping, come in praising, come in giving God honor, come in and giving Him glory, come in giving Him praise. Let's give Him, just give Him, hallelujah. Give Him the glory. Say hallelujah right where you are. Give Him honor. Praise Him. He's King of Kings. He's Lord of Lords. He's the mighty God. He's the Prince of Peace. He's the everlasting Father. We just worship you, King. Good evening. Good evening, Dawn. Good evening, Daisy. Good evening. Come on in. We welcome you to Kingdom Combustion. It's a season to get ignited, y'all. It's a season to magnify and glorify God, but it's a season to be activated. To start doing the things that you're called to do. Not just talking about it, but actually doing. Amen? So we're going to give each and every person a chance to get in, and then we're going to open up in prayer. The scripture tonight is coming from James chapter 1. And some of it is hot off the press because the Lord, as I was setting up, shifted something real quickly. And I, you know, want to encourage us tonight. Because sometimes, you know, we feel so discouraged, but God wants you to feel encouraged tonight. Amen. So it's 8 p.m. Let's open up in prayer. Father God, we just thank you for this time. We give you honor, we give you glory, and we give you praise. There is none like you, King, in all the earth. We just worship and adore you in our homes, in our cars, wherever we are. We bow down before you. Father, we thank you for this word tonight. We thank you that we're going to apply it to our hearts and we're going to apply it to our minds. And we're going to get activated for you in the kingdom of God. So we give you honor and glory tonight. In Jesus' name we pray and we say amen. Amen. And welcome, welcome everyone to Kingdom Combustion. I just wanted to share like two announcements before I get started. Just a reminder to Standard Bearer Ministries in New York. There's two Standard Bearers. There's upstate New York and there's downstate in New York City. But both are coming together and we will be celebrating a 10-year anniversary of Standard Bearer Ministries in New York. And Standard Bearer in Florida is 1 year old, but in New York is 10 years. So we'll be celebrating at the end, and I'm encouraging all those Standard Bearers and all those who want to attend the event, because it's at the Inn in New Hyde Park in Long Island. Please, it's time to purchase your tickets and get that done because it's filling up fast. I'll just say that. And it would be a shame that Standard Bearers don't get to the event because they delayed. Amen? The other exciting thing that's going on, we're going to be going upstate next week, and we'll be ordaining two pastors, which is Pastor Philip and Anjali Moise. So we're excited about that. They'll be countertop outreach pastors and worship pastors up in upstate New York in the Rochester area. Amen. So look forward for more, hearing more from them. So tonight the word is application. Oh my gosh, this word, I tell you. Application. What do you think about when you hear application? Let's go with that. Listen, what do you think about when you hear the word application? Just put it in the comments. What comes to your mind when you hear application? Come on, let's get interactive. Because I'm gonna explain some things that the Holy Spirit was sharing with me related to this word, application. What does that mean? Definition in Merriam-Webster says things like an act of applying. Okay, Elder Susan said something in operation. Sister Tanya Simmons says action. That's right. Right, application. It's like you gotta do something. You gotta do something. You gotta do something. Deaconess Desi said something that you want. Amen? Application. I'm going to encourage you after I teach this tonight that you really go and Google it or look it up in your dictionary. Some people still have dictionaries. And just look at this word and say, God, what are you trying to tell me about me? Because that's what I did with this word. But before I get started and talking a bit more about application, I want to go to James chapter 1. Because in this season, of application, of action, as Tanya wrote, as something in operation, as Elder Susan wrote, as something you want, as Sister Daisy want, stated. Let's go to James chapter 1. In James chapter 1, I'm reading in the NLT, and I've actually got my big monster Bible out. This is my Bible, y'all. She's just big and thick. And you can color in it too. And I encourage you to get back to getting your own Bibles. Don't always do everything on your phone, because a text will come in while you're trying to study and do the word. Amen? So I'm just encouraging you. So James chapter 1, I'm starting at verse 2. And it says, the heading is faith and endurance. And I want to encourage you tonight, even before I talk about application, because a lot of us, our faith is being tested. And it says, dear brothers and sisters, when troubles of any kind come your way, consider it an opportunity for great joy. So when things are coming at you, you got to look at it as great joy, especially if you're in the body of Christ and as a Christian. It says, verse 3 says, for you know that when your faith is tested, your endurance has a chance to grow. And when your faith is being tested, this is your season of growth. This is your season of expansion. So don't look at every negative thing or every setback as what is God doing now. You've got to look at it. You've got to apply the word of faith in your life. Amen? Let's continue. It says, verse 1 says, so let it grow. For when your endurance is fully developed, you will be perfect and complete, needing nothing. And I need you to hold on to that right there. Because you may go through some things. You may be tearing away from things. You're trying to shift things in your mind. You may be shifting things in your home. You may be shifting things in your finances. But it says, let it grow. Let your faith grow so you can endure. Let your faith grow. And then when you're fully developed, it says you will be perfect and complete, needing nothing. And I'm saying we need nothing. In the kingdom of God, there's no lack. So we're talking about application tonight. But I wanted to encourage you, because some people, their faith is being tested, and they're saying, God, where are you in all of this? And he's right there with you. But you got to give yourself a chance to grow. If you do everything right away, you may not be able to handle it. You know how your children say stuff, Mommy, I want to drive the car. When they're little, they're like, Mommy, I want to drive the car. And they're like 5. I know how to drive. Put the child behind the wheel. They don't know how to drive. So this is the thing with us, so that the Lord is saying, give me a chance. Give yourself a chance to grow, and then I will bestow everything on you, and you'll be lacking nothing. So let's go to the word application. Application is saying an act of putting something to use. So you got to put your faith to use. And then you got to endure. And then you'll lack nothing. Because then he knows he can trust you. Amen? Application has so many definitions, y'all. It's just not enough time to do it, but I'm going to do the best I can in the time I have allotted. So the next definition says, a use to which something is put, new applications for old remedies. Number B says, an act of administering or laying one thing on another, application of paint to a house. And you know, sometimes you, when you're getting your house painted, you want to see the whole thing painted. Elder Susan's house was being painted. And there's nothing like putting on that first coat of paint. And you're saying, oh my gosh, that's not the color. But when they put on the second coat, you say, oh my gosh, now it looks like the swatch I had. And that's what God is saying to you. He put a coat on you. You accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. But now you got to endure some things. You're going to have to walk out some things by faith. You're going to have to grow in him. You're going to have to apply the word to your life. And then when you look at it, a second coat will be on you. The Holy Spirit will be working through you and in you. And you'll be expressing that. But you got to apply the word to your life. Application. We're not paint. But God is looking for us to start to apply the word and be activated and walk it out by faith in Jesus' name. It says, a form used in making a request, filling out an application. You know, like you're filling out an application, and I'm saying this tonight because I was thinking about that as I was driving earlier today. The word is application. Some of y'all need to fill out some applications. Some of y'all are just sitting back, not applying for jobs, not applying for school, not moving forward in what God is saying, being fearful, and I come against fear even now in the name of Jesus. That now no weapon that's trying to form is going to prosper. That you will believe the Lord's report. And it is yes and amen for you. So some of you need to fill out applications. We'll talk about application tonight. But I'm saying apply your faith. Look for a greater horizon. The best is yet to come. Your latter days are going to be better than your former. And God is expanding the time now. This has nothing to do with age. This has everything to do with a heart that's surrendered to Him. Apply it to your life. So some of you all, y'all need to fill out applications. You're in a job too long. You're sitting there, because it's comfortable. But comfortable is not faith. I'll just leave that right there. Comfortable is not faith, because I can tell you, comfortable was not faith for me. But because I decided to say, God, even in the uncomfort, you are a comforter. That's what you have to remember. Even when you're not comfortable, He is a comforter, and you have to hold on to Him. Amen? We're talking about application tonight. Because application, you got to apply things to your life. You got to apply for things that you listen. There's things that God has doors that are already open for you that you just need to apply. But don't allow fear. Let faith move you. Don't let fear, hallelujah. Do not allow fear to arrest you to not move forward in the thing that God has for you. People's lives depend on you. I wanted to talk about application. I was, I'm here at the Refuge Retreat, which is in Standardbear, Florida. You know, our office is here and we do retreats here for leaders that are in the trenches. And we had a situation where there was someone that was in need. And because that person was in need, I sent out like an urgent message out to the team, and we had to give up our furniture so someone else could live in our space. You know, we had to give up the furniture so someone else could, you know, have a comfortable place. So I sent a picture of them, of the empty room. And within a day, I'm telling you, within a day, the room was filled and it was refurnished. And I'm saying to you, God is just looking for our yes. He's looking for our obedience. A lot of, I had put it out early in the week, our donation is someone else's salvation. Because of that act of kindness, not only did it open a door for me to be able to minister to someone, it ministered to the whole compound here, it ministered to the whole community, and all of the workers were involved moving the furniture and saying, you're the pastor here? You're the one that's, absolutely, because yes, pastors give, yes, apostles give, yes, prophets give. Yes, the fivefold gives. But we're going to apply some things to our lives. We're going to shift the trajectory where this thing is, you know, that all we do is take. No, the finances are needed to advance the kingdom of God. But we're applying ourselves to the work of the ministry so everyone can move forward in Jesus' name. So I exercise my faith, not knowing if the furniture was going to come, not knowing. You got to exercise, apply the word to your life in Jesus' name. Application. I'm looking at this one, number five. It says, a medicated or protective layer or material, an oily application for dry skin, like lotion. You need to rub this world. You see this word right here? You see this Bible? You got to rub this thing all over you. Rub it in your eyes. Rub it in your ears. Rub it all over your body. Because it's the word that works. God is looking for a people. He is looking for a tribe. He is looking for believers, not just receivers. He's looking for believers who want to move up forward by faith and apply their faith to the word of God and see great manifestations of His glory on earth. That's what He's looking for. So we don't have to look back. So I want to go back to James, and I want to go to verse 19. It says, understand this, my dear brothers and sisters. You must be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to get angry. And I was, you know, when I was younger, I used to get mad about a few things. Everything used to fire me up. But I realized it's better to start listening. And I'm encouraging you in this season, start listening more, talk less. See what someone is really saying. Because in that saying, you'll really hear, if you're listening to the Holy Spirit, you'll be able to discern what is really happening so you'll know how to pray for the person. Slow down, believers. Slow down. Listen. Accept what they're saying. Ask God to say, explain to me what's really going on, and then pray for the person. Let's continue. Verse 20 says, human anger does not produce the righteousness God desires. God doesn't want us to be angry and upset about, oh, I didn't get this, I didn't get that. No, no, no. He's teaching you patience. He's teaching you endurance. He's teaching you steadfastness. He's teaching you long suffering. And we got to stand. When you've done all you can, you must stand and stand again. Amen? So the key here, because I'm going to get to this application. It says, verse 21 says, so get rid of all the filth and evil in your lives. This is no time to be backpedaling and trying to explain and say, you know, God understand. No, he don't understand. If you want the things of God, if you're asking him to give you increase, if you're asking for your spouse, you're asking for your house, you're asking for all of these things, but you put nothing on the table, you're going to have to apply this word to your life. And you're going to have to get rid of some of the things that are distracting you from focusing on God. It says, and humbly accept the word God has planted in your heart, for it has the power to save your souls. When you receive this word in your life, when you read his word, something transforms in you. Something shifts in you. But you got to want to. God is such a sweet gentleman. He don't force us. He gives us free will. Free will to love him. Free will to accept his son. Free will to do it the way we want to do it, mess it up and fix it again. It's all free. But I'm encouraging you tonight, let's apply the word to our lives. So here's my key scripture. But don't just listen. This is verse 22. So just lock this in your memory. But don't just listen to God's word. You must do what it says. Apply it. Otherwise, you are only fooling yourselves. What do you say to that? When the word says that, I didn't say that. The word says it. It says, but don't just listen to God's word. You must do what it says. Otherwise, you are only fooling yourselves. One of the things I want to talk to us about finances. Let's talk about finances because that's usually a hot topic in the kingdom of God. We all say a lot of scriptures. You sow what you reap. Do you sow? So why do you think you're going to reap? Give and it'll be given back to you. Good measure. Press down, shake it up. Do you give? I'm talking about application tonight. Because I'm hitting a hot spot. Because one of the things I realize is that, you know, some people, you know, they back up from these things. But do you give? We'll give to so many other things. But when it comes to the kingdom of God and encouraging others and sharing with others, we all kind of backpedal and try to be thinking about, you know, what about me? What about my life? But what are we saying? Jesus paid it all. All to him I owe. There's a song that goes that way. Jesus paid it all. So, you know, I want to share something that the Holy Spirit said to me the other day. He said, yeah, you know that song you sing, Jesus paid it all to him I owe. So why do you think you owe everybody? Some of you all are crippling other people's lives because you keep sowing into their lives so they can't see God for themselves. So this is a hard truth today. Sometimes you're going to have parents, you're going to have to pull back and allow these young people to move forward on their own in the way that they feel they should go. And then pull back and allow God to massage them. Because sometimes only when they're at their darkest hour are they able to come back to him. And because we step in and we pay all they owe, ouch to somebody, because that must be for someone, because that's not in my thoughts. Because you pay all they owe and all to him, they can't Jesus paid it all. They never get to meet Jesus because they see you as the go-between. We're going to have to step out the way. We're talking about application tonight. I know that's some tough stuff. But if we're going to take the next generation into loving Jesus, we're going to have to teach them the hard truths. We can't do everything for you. You're going to have to apply this word to your life. And I'm not talking from a position of things that I did not do, because I did some of those very same things. And then I had to restruck and reevaluate what I was doing. Is that really helping my children? And I had to tote a narrow line. So we're talking about application tonight. What are you going to apply? What is the word that the Lord has given you on your life? You got to put it to use. Lots of people, you go to Bible study. This is my life scripture. But is your life lining up with the life scripture? You know, we love Jeremiah 29:11. You know, I know the plans that you have for me. Everybody wants good plans. What do you do when the plans sink and tank? Then you got to go back to James 1. It says, James 2, it says, dear brothers and sisters, when troubles of any kind come your way, consider it an opportunity for great joy. Are you excited when trouble comes your way? I went and visited several churches in the past couple of days, and I heard a statement that someone had lost something, and they said even in the losing, they were looking to see where they could serve Jesus all the more. Is that your position? Can you apply that to your life? Can you say that Jesus is all to you? Is he all to you? Is he all to you? Think about that. You're in your car, you're in your home, you're sitting back, you're relaxing. You put petitions before the Lord, because application, another word for application is your petitions. You put your petitions, you put your prayers, you put your supplication. What are the outcomes? Tonight, I want you to reevaluate where you are in your faith. Where am I in my endurance? Am I really applying the word to my life? And, when we came to Florida, we didn't understand why the Lord told us to expand in the midst of a pandemic. But I get it now. You got to give God some time to work. And if I did not endure, and I'm telling you, I kicked and screamed. Everybody knows it. I tell y'all quite often. I kicked and screamed, but I get it now. With now that we have Standard Bearer Flower Refuge, and that leaders in the trenches can come in and get respite and get encouragement and just get refreshed, so they can go back out and share the gospel, teach the word, prophesy, deliver, set free. But everybody needs a respite. But that was my thought about the application. I said, God, thank you for, listening to me whine. Because any of y'all whine to him and say, Lord, why me? Why I got to do it? Because sometimes you do. But I said, Lord, thank you for listening to me whine. Lord, thank you for not giving up on me when I wanted to give up. Lord, thank you for encouraging me and sending others to encourage me so I would stay. Because now, we're nowhere close to what the completion of this project is going to be, because it's God's glory that we're looking at. But the issue is that if I didn't keep applying the word when it got hard, I said, Father, no good thing are you going to withhold from me as I continue to walk upright. Even when I felt like I was on my knees, I didn't want to walk. He would send someone to encourage you. So part of the application process is, it may not be always a word that you read in the Bible, but God will send an angel, another believer. He'll send a baby to just encourage you to continue to take one more step. But I'm saying, this is your season of application. This is your season to apply the word. This is the time to speak healing over your body and apply that word so you can see breakthrough, and that the miracle working power of Jesus Christ will be evident in your life. This is the time to speak to your bank account. This is the time to speak to your children. This is the time to speak into your future. This is the time to let go of your past in Jesus' name. We're talking about application. We're talking about moving in faith. We're talking about endurance. We're talking about running a race. We're talking about Jesus Christ, who never leaves you. He's the author and the finisher of your faith. Apply it to your life. Some of you need to apply and stop crying. Because he has all your tears in a bottle. But as he's collecting those tears, what are you doing? Apply yourself. Move forward in what God is saying. It's bigger than you. That's why it's God. It can't, if it's something you can do, it's not a dream as far as I'm concerned. It's bigger than you. It's greater than you. It's better than you. He has great plans for you. But you're going to have to apply yourself to the word. You're going to have to seek his face. You're going to have to set some time for him. We set time for everything else. So wake up and spend time with him. Go walk and talk to him. Go on and sing and encourage yourself in the word. Sing to him, but give him the hallelujah. Give him the glory that's deserved. It's time to apply Jesus to your life. He is a balm in Gilead. Hallelujah to our King. This is just practical stuff. Thank you, Sister Daisy. His name is Jesus. Apply him to your life. Accept him as your Lord and Savior. But we got to get activated. We got to get activated. I want to encourage you tonight. Don't just be a listener. Don't just, you know, that was a good word. No, this is not what kingdom combustion is about. Kingdom combustion is about applying yourself. Some of you all need to go back to school and get the next degree. Some of y'all need to go and get your GED. It doesn't matter where you start, but you must start. You must apply the word to your life and expect that God is going to move forward. One of the things, I'll share this. When we stepped out by faith and started this expansion, we didn't see the finances to walk us through it. We had to step out and get this place by faith. And I want to encourage you with this. Faith is not mapped out. Faith is not mapped out. So you got to take the first steps, and then you got to allow Jesus to step in. You got to allow the Holy Spirit to guide you. That's why it's so important that you spend time with him. Because when you spend time with him, he will give you instructions for only you, so you'll know how to walk out to the next phase. So it's time to be elevated. It's time to be transformed. It's time to renew your mind. It's time to apply all that God has invested in you. Some of us have been Christians from yesterday, and some have been Christians for years. I don't care where you start. You can start from the beginning, or you can have been in this walk for a long time. It's time to apply. It's application time. So this is an application that Jesus already filled out for you. He shed his blood. So you don't have to go up on a cross for it. But there is purpose in your life. And in this season, in this moment, in this hour, I speak purpose in your life even now in Jesus' name. You will do great exploits for God. You will be a kingdom child, a kingdom king and a kingdom queen, a kingdom prince and a kingdom princess. You will move forward in all that he has called you to do. Step out by faith. Let the Holy Spirit lead you and guide you. Do not turn back. I'm encouraging you tonight. Because this is not an age thing. This is a determination thing. You apply the word to your life and watch what God does. And do not have small dreams. Think big. Think compounds. A lot of people just want a house. I want compounds. It's not about it, because it's not dependent on me. It's dependent on him. So when you take the weight off yourself, because you be trying to look at what you have and say, oh, Jesus, please help me. And he's saying, no, I can do whatever you want, but you don't believe me. So tonight, if you get nothing from application, apply your faith, apply the word to your life and walk it out. Endure the process and see the great things that God is going to do in you and for you. And not just for you, it's gonna help a nation. It's going to help a community. It's going to help children. It's going to help the elderly. It's going to help those that are incarcerated. It's going to help those on the street. You're going to see that there's a big dream that God has inside of you. And all you have to do is spend time and then walk it out by faith. So I want to end with the scripture. Dear brothers and sisters, when troubles of any kind come your way, consider it an opportunity for great joy. For you know that when your faith is tested, your endurance has a chance to grow. So let it grow. For when your endurance is fully developed, you will be perfect and complete, needing nothing. So we thank the Lord tonight that you need nothing. There is no lack in your household. There's no lack in your children's lives. There's no lack in your extended family, because you're in the kingdom of God. And in the kingdom of God, there is no lack. So God bless you all. I love you all. It's application time. So start filling out the applications, as well as applying the word of God to your life. I am Apostle Sonia Chambers. I'm the apostolic leader of Kingdom Advancement Alliance, and I'm the overseer of Standard Bearer Ministries upstate, Standard Bearer Ministries downstate, and Standard Bearer Florida. There's a lot going on, but we're expecting God to do the miraculous. So we thank you for tuning in. We thank you for all your support, but you lack nothing. And know with God, you have everything already, because Jesus paid it all. All to him you owe. Zero in the world is not a kingdom mindset. So I'm just encouraging you today. Some of that's going to have to marinate. Because we're in this world, but not of this world. And sometimes zeroing out, having a zero balance sheet in the world may not be a kingdom mindset. Because you may need to help others so that God can now shift and move on your direction. So I love you all. God bless you all. This is Kingdom Combustion, and we have ended. God bless you and good night.